Hi guys, my name is Nancy Loom and I am the Loom Detective. And today we're going to solve the mystery on how to make these adorable butterfly pencil huggers. I came up with this design myself from the wings and I did three legs on it. And this is an advanced design. So if you're a beginner, do not try this. Well, I wouldn't try this. It can be hard because you're using double bands and the bands tend to snap if you're not really careful. And I'm also using a different camera to record this video and a different background. So just let me know if you like this camera better or the other one. The other one I was using was a flip. So if you like the flip better, just write flip in the comments. And if you like this camera better, then just write camera. And then the background, if you like the pink one or the black one. Because I wanted to make my videos better and easier for you to make and just clearer in my instructions. So if you have any suggestions for me, please write those in the comments below. And also, I am starting out a new thing where I'm going to answer a question at the end of each video. So if you want your question to be featured in next week's video, please write that in the comment section below too. And please thumbs up this video. It really helps me out. And so let's get on to making this pencil hugger. So to make this pencil hugger, you will need your rainbow loom, your rainbow loom hook or a crochet hook. You will need rubber bands. You will need 57 of the color of, like, I guess the caterpillar part of the butterfly. You will need two bands for the eyes. You will need 26 of the border bands on the wings, and you'll need 26 of the inside colors on the wings. So grab your supplies and let's get started. So we're going to start by making the wings of our butterfly. So you'll need your loom set in the standard configuration, and then you're going to flip it around so the arrow is facing towards you. And now we're going to start by placing the border on one of the wings. So get your border color. Mine is going to be green. I'm going to take it, stretch it out, twist it, put it back on itself, place it from the middle pin to the pin on the left. So middle pin to the pin on the left. Then take another border band, stretch it out, twist it. So you're going to cap these bands, put it from the middle peg to the peg on the right. Now all the bands in this project are going to be double capped unless I say different. So just if I don't say what they are, then just assume that they're double capped. So now you're going to take another border band, stretch it out, twist it, put it from the second peg to the third peg on the right. Take another band, again just cap it, place it from second pin to the third. And you go down so you have three bands right here. And now we're going to start going in. So again, cap the band. Now we're going to move from this peg diagonally down to this peg right here. Then going to take another. You're still using the border color from this pin to this pin right there. And then going to take another capped band from this pin to this pin. And then you're going to another double capped band, this pin to this pin. Right there. Then you're going to take another double capped band, this pin to this pin, right here. Then another, again, double capped, this pin to this pin. Then one more border band, this pin to this pin. So you can see, oops, zoomed the wrong way. It looks like a butterfly wing. And so now we're going to fill it in. So, I'm going to take the color. You want to fill it in. Again, we're using double capped bands. And then you take it from this middle pin to the pin right below it. Right there. Then again, take another band, double cap it, and then place it from the second pin to the third pin. Then take another band, double cap it, and you just want to keep going down. Oops, the second part fell down. So you're going to have four bands right here. So you're going to put another one down here. So you have four bands here. You're also going to fill this in right here. So there's going to be four bands filled on this side. And again, going to be double capped bands. And so you just keep putting them on. I'd like you all to tell me if you like it when I say you do this to the top of your loom and I'll be right back. And so do you like it if I do it like that, where I stop the video and then I come back after I'm done? Or do you like it where I just go through the whole entire thing with you, like nonstop? Just write that in the comments below what you want. If you want me to like stop and come back, then write pause. If you want me to just keep going, then write play. Just an easy way for me to tell, because I'm not sure which way you guys would like me to do that. So let's just get back to the pencil hugger. So again, take your inside color, cap it, place it from this pin. So we're actually gonna skip right here where it goes in. You're gonna skip right here. You don't put any bands right there. And now we're gonna put one from here to here. And then take another capped band, place from here to here. Then another capped band, still using the inside color. We're just going to keep going all the way down. So you put one there. Oops, I dropped a bunch of bands. Put one here. And then you put one right here. And now we're going to put on our connector bands. So I'm going to use the same color as the body, because you can see that's what they are right here, these little bands that are connecting it to the kind of caterpillar part of it. You can see them on the side too, so you just pick whatever color you want for them. And now, so you're going to take one of those bands, stretch it out, twist it, put it back on itself. We're going to be making triangles. So on three pegs, but you're going to skip those three pegs and move to the next three pegs. So put it this peg, and this peg. And then take another band, the color of your connector bands, cap it, put it on these three pegs right here. Then I'm going to do another one. Stretch it out, twist it, put it back onto all three of these pegs. Can't get it. Okay. So you have three on the top part of the butterfly, and now we're going to put two more down here. So again, take a band, double cap it, and you're going to put it on these three pegs right here. So from this peg to this peg, this peg. And then you're going to take one more band, double cap it, and put it on the triangle below that. So you will have five capping bands, connector bands, I should say. And this is how your loom should look. So just check to make sure your loom looks like mine. And now we're going to cap it and loop. So I like to use the same color as my border, because this is the capping band right here, and it just looks like the rest of the border, but you can really choose whatever color you want. So again, I'm taking green. I'm going to wrap it around four times around this bottom pin. 4 times. So you take it once, twist it around twice, twist it around 3 times, twist it around 4 times. You have like 4 loops on there. Now we're going to loop. So you're going to take your hook, going to reach behind this capping band, grab the top band, pick it up, stretch it out, and move it up. Then you're going to reach back in there, stretch behind, grab that band, pull it up, move it to this. Now you're going to reach in and grab the pink, just the pink, move it up. And now you're going to loop this pink right up here. Loop that up. We're wanting to loop the pink first, and then the border will like connect it all together. So you're going to go on this side and loop all the pink. All the way up. Just go up the whole, go up the whole entire line. Just take it and move it up. So you have this whole line looped. And now we're going to loop the bottom border. So you pull back this band, reach in, grab it, and move it to the right. Then you're going to reach behind that. You're going to pull this band out, pull it up, and move it up top. Then you're going to reach behind the connector band, grab the green band, pull it to the left, then stretch behind those top bands, grab the bottom green, pick it up, move it to the left, then stretch behind these bands, grab that bottom band, pick it up, and move it to the right. You gotta be careful with these. Oops, I just lost it. So if that happens, just move around your peg. And so you can see it fell right back there. It's not a big deal. Just put your hand, put your hook, all those bands, grab that double capped band right there, pull it inside there, pick it up, and then loop it back over. It's very simple. And so now we're going to loop this pink. So take this pink up there. Then you're going to loop this whole line of pink on this side too. And now we're just going to loop the rest of the border. So reach in this band, pull it over, then you're going to reach behind the capping band, grab that band, move it up, reach behind that capping band. Oops, I only got half of that, but you just need to make sure you get that band. You can do that, you can loop one at a time, because sometimes if you don't have a metal hook, it kind of stresses on the hook. So just either way, you just pull them up. Then you move this right one over to this side. And now, instead of like looping this side in towards the middle, you are going to reach behind these bands, pull this band, pick it up. Sorry, it's kind of stuck. If that happens, just move the bands around on that peg, and then it becomes loose. And then put it back on your hook, move it to this, and this is where you're going to put the connector band. The slip knot. And so put your hook in here, stretch it back, stick it out, and I'm just going to grab a band. I like to use the same color as the border, and just take that and pull it in, move it outside, put it on your hook, take that one, this one, and just tighten it. And so this is what your butterfly wing should look like. Now we're just going to take it off. So again, I would use a metal hook to take this off. It's just the easiest to do that way. Oh, my hook is stuck on this. It's just, you can use your fingers, but because these are double capped bands, it's a little tricky to take it off of the loom. So I'm just going to pull this off. I'll be right back. This is how my wain looked when I took it off the loom. So you're just gonna like stretch it out a little bit. It's not that big of a deal, just can form it a little bit. And then so you have the right butterfly wing. And now we're going to do the same thing, but it's going to be opposite, because we want the right wing and the left wing. Because as you can see on this side, it looks pretty clean. Oh, actually, this side, you can see, it's kind of, you can see it attaches to the pink. But this side, it doesn't look like that at all. So this is actually the left wing. Sorry about that. So we're going to make this on the opposite direction. So you're going to take your border color and you're going to, again, using double capped bands, we're going to do the same thing. We're just going to start in the opposite direction. So we're going to put this band from this middle peg to the peg on the right. Then another double capped band from this peg to the peg on the left. There. Then another double capped band. This peg, go down. Again, you go down three times. So we'll have second time and the third time. And now we're going to go in again. So again, we're still using double capped bands from this peg to this peg, and then this peg to this peg. Now we're going to go back out again. And out one more time. And now you're going to go down one. And then we're going this way. Oops. There we go. And then we're going to add the inside. So again, take your inside color, stretch it out. You're going to go down the middle peg to that peg. And then you're going to go down that peg. Just go down all the way to here with double capped bands. And now, oops, we're going to go all the way down to this peg with the inside color. So we're just, you're just doing the same thing. It's like a mirrored image of the other wing. That way you can use, they both look the same, and you can use the clean cut side of it. If you have any requests for a pencil hugger tutorial that you'd want me to do or want me to make up, then please write it in the comments below, because I'm kind of running out of ideas of pencil huggers to make. So I have a few more still, but if you want me to do one, then just write it in the comments. So, and now, I'm going to go on this peg that goes down right here, and do two for right here. Right there. Now, again, I'm going to be doing the connector bands. So take your connector color, stretch it out. Put it not on these first three pegs, but the second three pegs. So double capped connector bands. You do another one right below that. There. Then another one below this one. And then going to go down on these three pegs right here. Make another triangle. And then you're gonna go one more triangle below that. And then you're going to do the connector band again. Just let me grab my band. Ran out of that color. So I'm going to take the band, wrap it around four times. 2, 3, 4. Now we're going to loop. So you're going to take your hook, pull back this band, grab the top pink, just the top pink. Pull it up, and then you're just going to go up. Pull all the pinks up on this, just this one line though. So you loop up, reach behind that loop, just keep looping up all the way up there. Now we're gonna go back to the bottom. I'm going to pull back this cap band, grab that band, move it over to the left, and then pull behind those bands, grab the pink, move the pink up, then move the pink up one more time. So we looped this whole row of pink and we looped these two pinks. Now we're just going to keep going with the border. So pull behind those bands, grab the bottom bands, move it over. Then you're going to reach behind, grab those two bottom bands. And again, you just go wherever they're supposed to go. You just loop them back to themselves. So again, we're going to go in towards the middle. You're going to reach behind all those bands. Grab the ones at the bottom and bring them over. So you went in towards the middle. And now we're going to go back out this way. And now, once you looped this one in, going to pull up the pink and go up. So just go up this whole entire line. Oops. I'm not sure what happened. I think I might have forgotten to double loop that one. So I'm just going to take it off. Take it off, double loop it again, and just put one end on this and put my hook through. Grab the other end, pull it in, pull it up, and so that's just a way to do it if that happens to you, and just keep going up, all the way up to the top. Now go back to the border bands where you didn't loop yet, reach behind that, pull them out, then move it behind all those bands, grab those bands, just pull it back and up, back, up. Then again, you're going to go in towards the middle. Sorry if my hands were in the way, I'll try to keep them out of the way now. And then loop this green band over to here. Always gets like stuck there, so just move your hook around those bands to loosen it up, and then move it over to this side. And now I'm going to put your hook into this last peg. See if I can do it without my hand blocking the way. Just move it in this peg, stretch it back, poke it out, and then take band, put it on that peg, pull it through those bands, pull it out, push it on there, pull it in right there, make your slip knot, and then you just take it off the loom, and I'll be back when I've gotten mine off. This is how it looked like when I took it off the loom. And so again, you just stretch it out and it will take form. And if you see like white through there, whatever color connector band is, it's fine because we're going to be pulling these out and it'll tighten it up and it'll be great. So you're going to find the side that you like best. I like this side. And then find the matching side on your other one and get those ready, because now we're going to make the caterpillar part of our bracelet. So again, you're going to have your loom in the standard configuration with arrows pointing towards you. And now I'm going to take band you want for the face, stretch it out, twist it, put it this peg to this peg, these two pegs. And then you're going to take another band, put it from this peg to this peg. Then another one from this peg to this peg. And we're going to be making like a hexagon shape and move from this peg to this peg right here. Then I'm going to take another band, put it from here to here, and then you're going to close off the shape. Always using double capped bands. So you have the little hexagon. Now you're going to fill it in. So I'm going to put one right there. Then you're going to do another capped band there to there. And now I'm just going to put on the eyes. So I'm going to take your hook and whatever band you're using for the eyes. You need one band per eye. So, or you could use pony beads. So put it on your band, on your hook, put the band on your hook, and then wrap it around 4 or 5 times, just really up to you. I'm doing 4 times, because that's what I normally do. 2, 3, 4. So you have 2 bands, each with 4 loops, so together you have 8 loops. You're going to take one band, and you're not gonna double cap it. You're just gonna put it on there, and then you're going to pull those eyes on there. Just take all of them, push them off the hook, so you have like a kind of a floppy mess right there. Put it on the second peg down on the left, the second peg down on the right. So you have it like that. Then you're going to need to separate your eyes, bring them like that, and then stick your hook in the middle of that band and bring it up. So it kind of forms a triangle. The eyes on it. And now we're gonna go on to the long part right here. And so you're going to, again, take a double capped band, going to move down, going to go down, I think 9 times, yes. You're gonna go down 9 times, just go in a straight line 9 times. So that's 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There's another band under there. Oops. That's 7. And then just 2 more. Okay. Now you're gonna cap your band 5 times. If you can't do 5, you can do 4 or as many as you can. Because I know some bands aren't very stretchy. So I'm going to do it 5. You can decide if you want to do 6, 7. 4 or 3. So, just really, it's up to you. Okay, I lost count of how many times I looped it. So, stretch out once, twice, 3 times, 4 times, 5 times. There we go. And And so you're not going to loop it yet. You're actually going to attach the wings. And so you need to get the connector bands of each side of the wing. You're going to see there's five right here. You're going to take the top one. Sorry, that was my dog. She goes crazy. So just pull this top connector band. Try to get the connector band. And you're going to place it on the third peg from the bottom of the chin. So one, two, three. So you're going to put it on that third peg right here. Just put it on top. So right now, it's just... mine got caught. Okay, so it's just like right there. Now, going to take the next connector band. It's a little tricky keeping it on same time as putting it on. So put it on the next peg. Then take this next one. You just keep going down for the five connector bands you have. So it's kind of going to be stretched out, and you kind of really gotta pay attention because they like to fall off. Just like push them down. I think that'd be the best way to keep them on. And be careful your slip knot doesn't get caught on the other pegs, because that happens to me all the time. It's a big pain. So just, again, you can just grab it with your hook, or if you can get it with your fingers. Put it on the next peg. Stretch it out one more time. I gotta do one more time. Take the last connector band. Put it right there. That last peg. So as you can see, it's stretched out on these five pegs. So, looks like that. You can just like push them down, because now we have to do the same thing with the other wing. So, yeah, it gets a little annoying. So, just take the top one, put it on that top peg. And now that you know where, like how many pegs down you're supposed to go, you can take the bottom one. So let me get it. It'd be easier to take the bottom one and put it on that bottom peg. Because now your butterfly is all stretched out. And now you just grab those other ones. Put that on, lost the other side of it. Put that on the second one. You know, this only happens when I'm on camera. It's just the way it is. Oh man. Finally, got it on there. Okay, so again, you just keep going down on all five pegs. So you have all your connector bands on the five pegs right there. And then, so, you have your butterfly wings right there, and you have them on all five pegs. And now we're going to make the legs. As you can see, it has three sets of legs, because I think butterflies have six legs. I'm not sure about that, but I think so. And it will stay on your pencil or hook much better than if it only had two. And plus, it looks kind of cool. So, you're going to take bands that you need for the legs. You will need 9 bands altogether. So you're gonna take the color that you want, put it around that hook 4 times, it could be 3, 5. It's not really a specific number, but I'm going to do 4. I'm just gonna move my bands in so I can grab them easily. And then you're going to take a band, double cap it, put it on the end of your hook, slide this off your hook onto that band, and then put it back on there. Then take another band, stretch it, pull it on, and pull it through. So you're going to do this, you're going to have 9 bands altogether being used for each leg. So you can just calculate that up. So you're going to just make 3 things of 9 bands long. So they're just going to be like long strings. So you're going to make 3 of those. I'm just going to come back when I make those. So I made these 3 legs right here. They're just kind of like facing everywhere. And so you're going to put the first leg on the third peg from the chin. I just call that the chin. So the third peg, same one where you started with the butterfly. So put that band on that peg, and then you're going to line it up so it's straight like this, and you're going to go through the back and put those loops onto your hook. So we have it like this, and then you're just going to kind of twirl it around a little bit, and then put it back on there. So it kind of makes like a little circle, and then you put it onto there. And so you have, if you just like stretch it out a little bit, you have it. So it just stays this way. And it's like, you can see like the hole through it. So you're going to do that on the third peg. Then you're going to go, you're going to skip a peg and put a leg on this one. Skip a peg and put a leg on this one. So it's like every other one. So sorry about it stopping so suddenly. My memory card came full and I had to go delete some stuff. But while I was deleting stuff, I figured out an easier way to put on the legs. Sorry. So we have our one leg on the third peg down. And now the easiest way is to just take the end, make sure it's straight, So you take the end, make sure it's straight, and go on the side and put your hook through all those loops and then put it where it's supposed to go. So we're going to skip a peg, put it on this peg. So just put that right there, and then you just put this one right on top of it. First it looks a little funny like that, but you just move this one side, move it over to the right, and then just move it up like that. And it's the exact same thing as this. So we're going to do that for this next one too. So you skip a peg, you go to that one, and then again, straight, put your hook through all those connectors, and you put them, all the capping bands, sorry. Then you put it on this next peg. And you just place it right on top, and this is what I did before, but I kind of forgot. So sorry for those of you who did it the hard way, but this is just an easier way to do for now. So you just move it up till it becomes just like that. And so now we're just going to loop the butterfly. So you're going to take your hook behind all those capping band, move it up, and then reach in, move it up, then reach in, move it up on top of that. And now here comes, oops, I dropped one of my bands. So I'm just gonna pull that off and grab those bands. Just gonna grab those 2 that I dropped. Okay, so this is a little difficult, but I'm just gonna grab them and then pull them back up onto that peg right there. And now this is kind of the harder part. So actually, I just figured out an easier way to do that. So you're just going to pull this down a little bit. You're going to reach behind all of those bands and get the bottom band. Sometimes it's easier just to look in the side
to figure out which ones are the bottom bands. Or you could always just move the bottom ones like that. Okay, I'm just gonna find the bottom one and I'll be right back. So I pulled it up and then you loop it to the next place and then you reach the bottom band and loop it up again. And then again, you just push this back, loop up that band, and very gently just move it up and stretch it until it can fit over that top. That's the best way to do it. It just is. So reach down again, grab the bottom one. It's mostly tense on the leg pegs, so just move this band up. I have to say that this part is really difficult. So if you're a beginner loomer, I do not suggest doing this. So just loop up. Like my band just broke. So I'm just gonna go fix that real quick. And so I fixed the broken band. Now you just loop it up, reach into this peg, grab that band, loop it up, and then reach into this peg, grab the top bands, and move it up, the top double capped band. And then you're going to just continue up in the middle, go up to the top, and then you're going to reach in, go on the sides, and then reach in again, grab the sides, and then you're gonna loop up and in towards the middle. So this week's Q&A question is from Kelly Mullis, and her question is your last name really Loom? Kelly Mullis, it's not. That would be a really cool last name though. So that is not my last name. And so if you have a question for next week's video, type that in the comment section below. Please like this video and subscribe.